Hi, this is Dan, and I am here with Marl's play of Risk Global Domination. So we're going to go in single player, and we're going to stick in Europe. But I think we're going to play in zombie mode. So what do we have going on? Once again, we're kind of in France. Although if this is your first episode, you don't know what I'm talking about. The previous episode I played in Europe, and our troops were kind of clustered in France. So we do have a lot of troops in Britain and France again, seem like the way to go. Probably want to try to lock down Britain first, because it's so much more defensible. It's a little bit hard to make out what's going on some of those dice. Any red pips on there, red backgrounds. Can't really get these guys anywhere good. So I guess we'll just stop there. Valentino's got Germany. That's pretty impressive. Claire the Bear. Yeah, Claire is not in a great situation. She doesn't really have any obvious moves that I can see. I guess she's gonna try for the Ottoman Empire, but that big stack of yellow and then there. It's kind of gonna screw it up for her. Yeah, nobody's really setting up to attack yellow here, which is not ideal. Dolores could, but she's probably gonna attack that blue one to her right. Well, she's attacking yellow, but not the right one, yeah. Well, and she rolled very poorly. And we're not really in a great position to do anything there. So, I mean, well, we could get there, and we're trying to get France. But I really want Britain. So I'm just gonna go up here. He's got something. Six troops for the German Empire. That part of it sucks. Zombies. Well, she could get Russia here. That's probably a good move for her. She didn't really do that in a way that left her troops in the right place, but at least she has a region. I think I want to try to bring these guys across. And in the process, break up Germany. Yeah, if we can get our dice to ever cooperate. This is not ideal. I would prefer to leave my back country actually a little bit supported in case we get a zombie outbreak, but we're losing so many fights that I need to move them up onto the borders. Yeah, and them building up so much in Spain is not great. She's doing some damage, but she's leaving herself so weak that she's not going to be able to maintain that. Well, like we've got to fight these zombies, but I want to keep breaking this up. I just don't want that on my border. Alright, so clear the barrier this time might actually get the Ottoman Empire if she. Nope. Oh no! I wasn't even paying attention to what was going on up there. Yeah, I've letting these zombies get way out of hand. I think I've been destroyed. Frustrating. Yeah, the zombies didn't attack very intelligently there. Which, I mean, I guess they were zombies, so that's less of an apt criticism, I guess, in their case. Yeah, I guess the danger of playing back to back like I'm doing is I was remembering things from the previous game that like I had a really strong defense up there and I didn't need to worry about. Okay, well this kind of sucks, so let's see if we can hold off. All right, well, that, I don't know. We're in just really terrible, terrible shape right now. Yeah, the constant drain on our troops of trying to keep Germany from being powerful has been a problem. And now the zombies are kind of completely out of control. This, I don't know. I feel kind of bad here that this is kind of the slow motion disaster is mostly my fault. Because I was kind of blocking anyone else from ever attacking here and I didn't clean up the mess. We do have a mandatory trade-in. That's still this terrible one. I mean, we might as well not do that, I guess. I don't know what this is. Okay, it gives them troops in Portugal. I actually watched what was happening there as it happened. So I'm gonna still try to escape to Britain here. Attacking against zombies, you do have a nice advantage. You know, both you have more dice and you win ties. Unfortunately, we need to stop there. Bad luck on the dice rolling here. I mean, I don't know how statistically it matches up, but it felt like we could have done much better on that turn and just didn't. Yeah. And we're still in it. I don't really know how. If we can pull this one off, it's going to be amazing. Well, I'm going to do this because we need something to change up the dynamic here. So I think we're gonna stop there. Send three of these guys down. Actually, four of them. I mean, there's not, well. When you're on offense against the zombies, you can do a lot of damage, so maybe it's not the end of the world here. And I think the zombies are gonna be going after them more than me. Although the yellow guy has Germany again, which is, it's like every time I get something, it's like, oh no, I have Germany now. Right, hopefully the zombies are going to take it away from him. Yes. Yeah, they are doing a lot of damage. So she's got one territory. And she just traded in all her cards. No, don't go there. Oh, that's what I was gonna do. So I'm going to weaken them because I don't think I have the strength yet to get all the way down into Spain. Yeah, I have to stop there. Oh man, they've got the neutral empire, so. So I'm not sure if the regions actually matter to the zombies, because I don't know what they're if they play by different rules or not. But I think what she's doing here is good. Right here, I'm mostly just trying to weaken them rather than conquer. Because I would rather conquer France if I can. I don't think that I really can. Man, that was terrible luck. Bets that he's going to try to take over Germany again. I guess I can't really blame him because that's what I would probably be doing in his shoes, but from my perspective, it's kind of annoying. This entire game, it's like Germany has just been pulsing on and off into existence. Is gone. Again, I'm thankful for what she's doing here. That's worth doing. So let's put four here. rest here. Oh, man. We're gonna need at least a little bit of luck here, but I think if I finally have the numerical advantage, I think it's gonna be time to take out the Iberian Peninsula here. Except we no longer have the numerical advantage. All right. And this is, I don't know, well, I mean, we have the British and French empires, maybe that's going to be enough. So, I mean, I want to go here, but then maybe it also makes more sense to just try to take over Germany. And get the I think getting the troops makes more sense. Assuming we can get it, which is not a guarantee. Yeah, we didn't get where we wanted to be. Yeah. I'm gonna stop there. This is maybe I should have put some back there. And this is just to weaken Denmark a little bit. So we don't have to leave so many troops behind. All right. Well, that was terrible. And it's so hard to get momentum. Was good. Yeah. Hope she does not attack me. No, don't do that. Oh man. Come on. We're against the zombies here. Okay. So let me put. Five there. Four there. I was going to say I'm going to turn on Blitz, but I think it's too dangerous. So we have the numerical advantage, so this should be, well, not anymore. But with both the new numbers and per roll advantage, apparently we're gonna find a way to lose. So that costs us a lot, but now we no longer have a threat behind us. So hopefully the undead will go after blue. But I'm feeling like this is winnable at this point. I think we're gonna hold all of our regions here, which is the big thing. This and then. Well, basically, I want everything. So let's do that. getting a bit impatient here. Well, that was not how it was supposed to go when I turned on Blitz. That's why I don't turn on Blitz. All right. I'll have to fix that later. I have to remember she doesn't have the zombie disadvantage on her dice. This is nerve-wracking fighting the zombies, because it's like your instincts are all like different, you know, like you're tuned to have a feel for the probabilities of normal combat. All right, this is okay. So we need to reinforce here. It's not great, but I think this'll last. All right, well, that wasn't too much of a disaster. All right. I'm gonna do this in Blitz because I'm very impatient at this point. It feels like it's been going on forever. And I don't think we can win outright here. So actually, let's stop that. Which means our borders are a mess. Hey, now. I get 27. That's a lot, but I mean, they don't place them ideally. Yeah, that was. I kind of didn't have the whatchamacallit, the kind of troop strength to be playing that last turn the way I did, where I was just impatient and trying to sweep through. We still have to play it smart, unfortunately. Do that. So I'm going to try to sweep through this way. Even though I just said I shouldn't be playing this way. It's this game has gone long enough that it has I need to take some shortcuts. See, I don't really understand how the zombies get like the troop numbers. Please don't break. Yes. Ow. This takes just so long. Please don't conquer anything in England. Okay. I'm just so tired of this game. I like it. Not, I'm not sick of the game in general, but it's like this particular session has been going on for like it feels like a zillion years. So I'm playing more recklessly than I ought to. Let's say so it might be 865. It's 13. Oh wow, too late now. It might just be they're doubled. All right. Whew. Now we get 33. I think I'll just put them here. Hey, that one was that was a long one. At least it felt long. Let me look at my recording. Well, only a little over an hour. All right. So I guess the it felt longer because we were in such a bad place for so long, and it was so such a grind there at the end of like pushing forward and then getting pushed back and forward and back and but a bit of a roller coaster. I thought we were destroyed. But we ended up winning, so that's interesting. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed watching and hope you come back next time. Bye.